Myself, Mr. Mate HT, Department of Botany, RBNB College, Srirampur. So today, we are going to study the TYBSC Botany class, paper first, BO 331, that is the Cryptogamic Botany, and from this, topic number 2, Algae. So today, we are going to study the remaining characters of the algae, remaining general characters of the algae, from this, number 1, that is the flagella. In algae, there are different types of the flagella. For example, heterokont flagella and isokont flagella. The flagella which are unequal in length, they are called as the heterokont flagella, and flagella which are isokont, that means they are equal in length. For example, in Chlamydomonas, both the flagella are equal. So such type of a flagella are called as the isokont flagella, and this is found in the Chlamydomonas. And when such a type of flagella are there, one is small and another is very large, such a type of flagella are called as the heterokont flagella. So this is unequal and this is the equal. So there are another types of the flagella are also. For example, these quadriflagella type of flagella are also there. Now these are the anteriorly inserted flagella, but in some form, laterally inserted flagella are also there. So these are anteriorly inserted and these are laterally inserted. Now such type of different types of flagellation of the flagella are found in the algae. Now next, that is the most important point, that is the reproduction in algae. Reproduction in algae. Now algae reproduces by 3 different types of the methods, that is vegetative, asexual and sexual. So from this, number 1, that is the vegetative reproduction. Now when the alga are unicellular, then the type of vegetative reproduction is the cell division. So such a type of cell division reproduction is found in when the alga are unicellular. For example, chlorella. Chlorella is unicellular alga. If such a type of algae are there, when they have a single cell, then their reproduction takes place vegetatively with the help of a cell division. Now second, that is the fragmentation. Now such a type of reproduction, vegetative reproduction, is found in the filamentous algae. Now here the filament breaks into number of fragments, and each fragment has a capacity to develop into a new thallus of the alga. For example, in Cara plant, there are special type of structures. They are called as the amylum stars. They are called as the amylum stars. Now these are the special reproductive vegetative body. They are full with the starch and their shape is like a star. So they are called as the amylum stars. When they get detached from the parent plant, they have capacity to develop into a new thallus of the Cara, and they are like this. So this is the amylum star, and they are found in Cara plant. These are the specially vegetative reproductive structures. So this is about the vegetative reproduction. Second, that is the asexual reproduction. In algae, the asexual reproduction takes place with the help of different types of the spores. For example, zoospores. These are the zoospores. They are found in Eulothrix. And these zoospores have capacity to develop into a new thallus of the Eulothrix. Now this is the zoospore. There are another different type of the examples. For example, autospore, hypnospore, oplanospore, cysts are also there, echinites are also there. Now these are different types of the asexual spores which are important for the asexual type of reproduction. Now that is the third, that is the sexual reproduction. It is again of the 2 different types, sexual reproduction. Number one, that is the isogamous. Now here, both the gametes are equal in their size, in their structure, in their behavior. When such a type of gametes unites with each other, then that type of sexual reproduction is called as the isogamous type of sexual reproduction. For example, both the gametes are same in their size and in their structure. So such a type of gametes are called as the isogametes. And when they unite with each other, then that type of sexual reproduction is called as the isogamous type of sexual reproduction. So this is the number one. Now number two, that is the heterogamous. On the basis of reproductive structures, on the basis of gametes, now this heterogamous reproduction is also of the two types. First, that is the unisogamous. Here, both the gametes are different in their size. Their shape is the same, but their size is different. For example, the structures are like this. Generally, this is the male gamete, which is a small entity, mostly active. And this is the female gamete. It is very large and it is less active. When such a type of gametes unite with each other, then that sexual reproduction is called as the unisogamous type of sexual reproduction. Now here in a heterogamous, there are again different types. That is the oogamous. Now here a special type of reproductive structures are getting developed. For example, antheridia. That is the male reproductive structure, and female reproductive structure is called as the oogonia. Now this antheridia gives the antherozoid, while oogonia gives the egg. So this is the male reproductive structure and this is the female reproductive structure. Now here antheridia and oogonia are specially developed reproductive structure. They have outer protective covering. So they are a special structure, that is antheridia and oogonia. Antheridia gives the antherozoid while oogonia gives the egg. Now this antheridia is generally small in size as compared to the egg. Egg is a large in size and they unite with each other to form the zygote. That means after fertilization, zygote is get formed. Now algae shows a special character after zygote formation. This zygote is get formed, but this zygote does not get developed into the embryo. But there is a meiotic differentiation takes place, meiotic division takes place, and there is a formation of the meiospores. Now the number of a meiospore is different in the different algae. It is according to the algae. Then each meiospore has a capacity to develop into a new thallus of alga. So this is the special character of the algae. That is, zygote does not develop into the embryo, but a meiotic division is there which develops the meiospores. The number of this meiospore is different in the different algae. And these meiospores have capacity to develop into a new thallus of the alga. Now the last character, that is the life cycle. Now in algae, in general, there are three different types of the life cycle, that is haplontic, diplontic, and third, that is haplodiplontic or diplohaplontic. So the first, that is the haplontic. When in the life cycle, the haploid stages are dominant, then such type of life cycle is called as the haplontic type of life cycle. Second, that is the diplontic. When the diploid stages are dominant in the life cycle, then that life cycle is referred as a diplontic type of life cycle. And third, that is haplodiplontic, or it is also called as diplohaplontic. When both the haploid and diploid stages are equally dominant, then such type of life cycle in algae is called as the haplodiplontic or diplohaplontic. Next point, that is economic importance of the algae. There are different types of the economic importance of the algae. For example, number one, algae in industry. For example, agar is extracted from the Gracilaria. It is used, this agar is used in different types of the laboratories. Now second, there is the alginic acid. It is extracted from the laminaria. The next, algae in agriculture. For example, nostoc. This nostoc is called as the blue-green algae, and there are such type of different types of the blue-green algae, and they fix the atmospheric nitrogen and they prepares the BGA biofertilizer, which is rich with the nitrogen compound. The next, that is the algae in space travel. And the example is chlorella. The multiplication rate of this algae chlorella is very fast, so it is used as a food in the space travel. Then algae as food and fodder. Again, there are different types of the algae which are used as food and fodder. For example, sargassum, laminaria, etc. are there. So these are some economic importance of the algae. The next point, that is the classification of algae according to V.J. Chapman and D.J. Chapman in 1973, up to classes only. Now they use different types of the biochemical and morphological characters. Now these biochemical and morphological characters are, for example, type of a pigment, now there are different types of the pigments in algae. For example, chlorophyll A, B, C, D, phycocyanin, phycoerythrin, phycoxanthin, etc. are there. So this is the most important biochemical character for preparation of the classification. Now second, that is the color of the algae. Now in algae, again there are different types of the colors. For example, blue, green, yellow, brown, etc. And these colors are based on the type of a pigment, that means which type of a pigment is present in the algae. The third character, that is the structure of algae. Structure of algae. Now there are unicellular to multicellular, different types of the structures are found in algae. For example, unicellular are there, multicellular are there. In multicellular, there are filamentous, there are heterotrichous, there are colonial, etc. structures are there. So there is a great variation in the structure of the algae. So this is also the morphological character of the algae for the preparation of the classification. Then next, that is the phylogeny of algae. Now this is related with the evolution. Now type of the reserved food material. Now in algae, again there are different types of the reserved food material. For example, fat is there, laminarin is there, oil is there, etc. Different types of the food materials are there. Then most important point for the preparation of the classification, that is the flagellar condition. Now there are the different types of the flagella, that is the heterocont, isocont flagella. They are inserted toward the upper side, or they are also inserted toward the lateral side. So this is the most important morphological character for preparation of the classification. Then next, that is the type of reproduction. Now in algae, there are three different types of the reproduction. That is vegetative, asexual and sexual. And again, these are the three different types of the reproduction. Again, it shows the subtypes. So there is variation in the reproduction of algae. So it is also important character for the classification. And the classification is like, now Chapman and Chapman has divided all the algae into two groups. 11 divisions and 15 classes are there. And they are prepared this on the basis of different types of the morphological and biochemical characters. So the first group, that is the prokaryota. And in prokaryota, there is only one division, which is called as the cyanophyta, in which all the blue-green algae are included. And the class is the cyanophyceae. Now, the second group, that is the eukaryota. Here, major algae are included in this group, which is called as the eukaryota. And it has 10 different types of the divisions. So, the first division, that is the rhodophyta. And on the basis of a color, they are called as the red algae, and it shows only one class, that is the rhodophyceae. Then second division, that is the chlorophyta, and it is called as the green algae, because the chlorophyll pigment is dominant here, and it is divided into the three different types of the classes, that is the chlorophyceae, prasinophyceae, and charophyceae. So these are the three different classes in the division chlorophyta. Then third division, called as the eugluonophyta. This group is called as the eugluonoids, and there is only one class, which is called as the eugluonophyceae. Then fourth division, that is the chloromoniadophyta, and these algae are called as the chloromonads, and there is only one class, that is the chloromoniadophyceae. The next, that is the fifth division, that is the xanthophyta. They are also called as the yellow green algae on the basis of a color, and there is only one class, that is the xanthophyceae. Then sixth division, that is the bacillariophyta. All the diatoms are included in this division, bacillariophyta, and there is only one class, that is the bacillariophyceae. Then next class, seventh class, that is the chrysophyta. Now again, they are called as the golden brown, because their color is a golden brown, and there are two classes, that is the chrysophyceae and hepatophyceae. Then eighth division, that is the pheophyta. They are called as the brown algae, and there is only one class, that is the pheophyceae. Then the ninth division, that is the pyrophyta, and they are called as the dinoflagellatian. And there are two classes, that is the dinoflagellatian and desmophyceae. And the last division, that is the cryptophyta, which is called as the cryptomonads, and there is only a single class, which is called as the cryptophyceae. Thank you.